So are you ready to wrap up our target trade here? We've done a lot of good work on this already. Let's just remind ourselves. We worked hard to identify the candles where we were going to establish confluence. Of course, we had our Fibonacci zone. We've done our targeting using confluence targeting and ABC targeting. Now the last thing that we can do is start to add in a little bit of a time component by layering our Fibonacci angles on top of it. So first, let's do it textbook, and then I'm going to show you a little tip or a little trick to help you get even more out of those Fibonacci angles. So textbook tells us that we begin right where we did our range drawing for the confluence zone, and we end the angle where we began the range drawing for the confluence zone. Now, if that's not confusing, I don't know what is, but it's really simple. This candle and this candle. The two candles were used to establish the ranges for confluence. And we're gonna grab the Fibonacci fan tool. And of course, this tool has to work left to right, so that's why that was a little gnarly there, confusing. And how'd we do? That's pretty good, isn't it? You can see that we're getting resistance here, and I like the fact that this line is coming through confluence and it's pretty close, but it's not quite perfect. However, things are lining up over here. It looks really good. And so here's a little tip for you. Just like you did with your Fibonacci range drawing with the support and resistance tool, and we talked about the additive components of that, so you can start stacking them once you understand the grid. Well, you can do the same thing for fan lines as well. And we can start another fan line right from the same origin, but now that we have this 50% line going right through, giving us a perspective, we can use that as a guide and get ourselves a few more fan lines just below and see if they line up as well. So let's do that. Let's go ahead and get another fan line here, starting at the exact same place that we drew originally, and I'm gonna just come and measure out this 50% line, like so. I'm trying to get it exact. There we go, that was perfect. So now you can see we've got 1, 2, 3 additional fan lines, and what I love about this is this one in particular comes right through time, price, and confluence. Literally, if you can just see right there, X marks the spot where your fan line's coming through, confluence is coming through, and price is coming through. Actually, this candle exactly is the one that bounced off from that support zone. So now that we've worked hard to establish this, we've done all the confluence and all the analysis required, we said that this should last for years and years, well, months and months, up to years in the future, right? So let's see how well this worked. We're gonna zoom out, pull our chart over, and see how well we did. In fact, all the way up to almost current events, actually, no, not current events, up through 2013 is where it finally broke down. So we were doing this work right back in here, January to May of 2012, and look how well this worked. All the way up to resistance, support, support, resistance, resistance, and then it tried to act as some resistance here and finally broke down going on into 2013. So from March of 2012 all the way through, if we're really honest with ourselves, we'll say September of 13. From March 12 to September of 2013. That's pretty impressive. And that's the power of really working hard to get your grid focused and then using some Fibonacci tools to do extensions and projections into the future. So that's Fibonacci angles. That was a lot in this one session. We've had angles and entrances and targeting and stops. Now it's time to go do a little bit of homework, practice this on your own. When you're ready, jump into the final session with me. And as always, if you have any questions about this, please come to Trading Lab. I'll be glad to talk through it with you. We can do an example and let you see in real time how this works out. So go have fun with your Fibonacci angles. And when you're ready, jump in. Let's make sure you get your homework done. And then I'll give you the answers to the homework so you can check your work. I'll see you in the homework session.